Dear student, how are you? Okay, in this class is here Luz Kelly, Natalia, and Sebastian. Edward had problems with the internet, yes. And Luz Adriana can connect it and no more. Okay. Well, tell me, Luz Kelly,
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon, who talking? ¿Quién me está hablando?
Teacher Rubiela, es que no pude estar en la clase, en la primera clase.
What happened, Rubiela? What was the problem? What was the problem? ¿Cuál fue el problema?
Oh, because no tenía acceso a internet.
Okay. Rubiela, please, you're introducing yourself.
Okay.
As to introducing, yes.
Okay. My name is Rubiela Gallego Garcia. I'm 47 years old. I live in Cali with my husband and my daughter. I studied bachelor and foreign language and English.
Okay. What do you like in this free time, Rubiela?
Profe, repeat.
What do you like in your free time? ¿Qué haces en tu tiempo libre? What do you like in your free time?
Okay, teacher. Estudio. I study.
I study, watch TV with your children.
I study, I read, book,
Okay, very good, Rubiela. Okay, well. Play, my dear students, the topic for today is game and sport. Ah, excuse me. Luz Kelly, can you say, Rubiela, what was the topic the last class? Luz Kelly, please. Yes.
Repeat, please.
Okay, what was the topic the last class? ¿Cuál fue el tópico de la clase pasada? What was the topic?
The topic is simple, present simple.
The topic was, porque estás hablando en pasado, ¿no? The topic was, el tópico fue. The topic was.
The topic was de present simple, simple, daily routine. Y en
frequency adverbs.
Frequency adverbs.
Okay, very good. Okay, Sebastian, please. Can you give me a daily routine about your best friend, your mother, your wife, or your girlfriend, or your daughter, or your son, please?
Yes, teacher. The daily routine in my cousin.
Oh, yeah, very good.
She wakes up at 8:30.
Wake up. Pay attention, Sebas. Wake up. She wake up. Wakes, okay. Wakes up.
She wakes up. She wakes up at 8:30 a.m. And she always wash your health, your cell phone, and they always then take a shower, and usually she checks her message only it's necessary, and then she have lunch at 1:30 p.m. and she depends and watch movies or series.
Okay, very good, excellent. I don't understand the part when you say, I forget, se me olvidó anotarla. Dijiste una parte donde no te entendí mucho después que ella y desayunaba, ¿qué era lo que hacía? ¿Me disculpas? ¿Qué querías decir?
No, que ella almuerza a la 1:30, que depende si ella...
Have dinner, have lunch. Have lunch, ¿ok? Esa parte yo no te la había escuchado, discúlpame. Ok, tell me, please. Natalia, what is the daily routine you spend for the person?
Daily routine is my sister.
Yeah.
Well, she wakes up at 7 o'clock in the morning before getting out of bed to pray. And then has her breakfast around the 7:30 o'clock. She entered class at 18 o'clock and almost always finish class between 10 o'clock or 2:20 in the morning. He ate an snack and performs his exercise routine, taking the dog.
Exercise.
Okay, very good. Okay, very good. He is the good for a walk and the ritual at the 1 p.m. to have lunch, and the 2:30 after that he sits down to do his work and finish at 5 p.m. We watch television and check his network, eat a snack at the 5:30, and the shares time with his family between in the 6 and 7 at night, and at the 8 he has dinner and goes to bed at the 10 p.m.
Okay. Excuse me the question, Natalia. You are reading the daily routines? ¿La estás leyendo?
Yeah.
Okay. Pay attention. Watch TV. Watch TV. Watch TV.
Okay.
Watch. Watch. No,
watch
no sé cómo. TV. Watch. Watch. watches. Si estás hablando de ella, sería watches. Aprendan a usar los plurales, perdón, no los plurales, sino la regla de la tercera persona con en los verbos, ¿no? Ojo con eso. Bueno, en estos momentos, okay, rápidamente, thank you for your daily routine, the daily routine, your cousin, me dijiste, ¿era de tu sobrina o tu sobrina? Ah, excuse me, la de Sebastián era la de la prima, si no estoy mal. Ok, bueno, yes. En estos momentos, listo, en estos momentos, you look at some expression and you guess what is the sport, ¿sí? Ustedes van a observar unas imágenes and you try to guess the sports, ¿ok? Pay attention. Give me, can you see the presentation, the video? ¿Pueden ver el video? Yes or no?
No.
Oh, wait, give me a moment. I share again the presentation, don't worry. I think that you, I thought that you least saw the video. And now I share again. In this moment, yes, but so? Can you see the presentation, the video? ¿Pueden verlo?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, and I the, y si lo agrandé, ¿lo pueden ver? The complete screen, can you can see? ¿Pueden ver la pantalla completa?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, buddy. Okay. What is the sport? Tell me, Sebastian, what is the correct word for this sport? ¿Cuál sería esta palabra, este deporte?
¿Tenis?
No. Luz Kelly, please. O ya Natalia, o Rubiela, o... ¿No? Pay attention here.
Basketball.
Hey, pay attention.
Okay.
What?
Okay.
Give me again, excuse me.
Okay.
A ver. Fútbol. Fútbol o soccer. Pero en este caso, soccer es para los americanos. Aquí para los británicos sería fútbol, ¿ok? Very good. Natalia. No.
Teacher, volleyball.
Volleyball. Very good. Ah, tennis. Forget the stop. Okay, continue. What is the sport, ya Natalia? Natalia? What is the sport, or Luz Kelly, or Sebastián, Rubiela, tell me please. No? Do you know the what is the sport? Okay, don't worry. Handball. Handball, okay? What What is the sport? Sebastian.
Cricket.
Cricket. Very good. Cricket.
Baseball.
A ver. Archery. Está fácil. What is the sport, Natalia? It's very easy. Or Lux Kelly, Rubiela, please.
Boxing.
What is the sport? No.
Rugby.
Okay. What is the sport? Natalia.
Hockey.
Oh, very well. Hockey.
Okay.
It's very easy. Baseball. And finally, what is this?
Pero tenía una pregunta,
¿qué es esto? No. Gap. En gap, ¿ok? Nos puso a pensar ese jueguito, ¿no? Okay, you are thinking. She was thinking with this plane. Okay, pay attention here. In this moment, I share again, pay attention, the new video you had will attend it because you have will attend it because in this video you have choose the correct word, the correct answer. For some question, okay? What happened? I don't find the... Oh, my God. Esperen un momentico. No, que no me empiece. Ahora sí. A ver, aquí está. Okay, and this is here. Okay. Look at, can you see the new video? ¿Pueden ver el nuevo video?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Pay attention. Listen well the conversation in these persons, in these people, excuse me, in these people, and the video stop, and when it stop the video, you can see the question with some answers, okay? And you have to choose the correct answer about this question, okay? Pay attention.
What's your favorite sport, Gemma?
I love rugby. It's so...
Okay. Can you see the... Pudieron escuchar, ¿verdad? Can you see, listen? Can you listen in the video, okay? Okay. Well,
rugby.
Yes, words. Gemma favorite sport? Por allá escuché ya que era rugby. Very good.
It's so exciting. I often watch games at the stadium. When our team scores a try, the crowd cheers so loudly.
Sebastian, what is the correct word for this question? What happens when her team scores a try? The crowd cheers loudly. They do a dance and sing. They shout and yell, or they gay forward. What is?
Profe, se me había ido. The option A. Yes.
Okay, very good.
How about you?
I love basketball because it's so fast. I went to a game last week.
Okay, Natalia. Natalia, please. Why does he love basketball?
It's fast.
Very good.
Last week, one of our team's players made a three-point shot from halfway across the court. It was amazing.
Okay. Elus Kelly, from where did one of the players make a three-point shot? What is the correct answer? No? One student that helped to lose Kelly. Sebastian, can you choose the correct word or no?
No, teacher.
Okay, please, from all the ways across the court. O sea, ellos pueden cruzar la cancha, ellos pueden atravesarla. Si eso es lo que quiere decir él, ¿ya? Okay.
It was amazing. Do you play any sports?
I like to play tennis. I have a good racket.
Okay. What sport does she like to play?
Tennis,
very easy.
I have a good racket, and I go down to the courts at the leisure center to play. How about you?
I like boxing. It's a good workout, and it's challenging too.
Do you need?
Okay, what sport does he like?
Boxing.
Do you need any equipment?
Yes. You need gloves, a mouth guard, and head protection.
Okay. Which pipe or equipment don't you need for boxing, Natalia? Pay attention here. Don't you need? Yes?
Yeah. Protection.
Head protection in the boxing, I consider yes.
Gloves, teacher.
What?
Gloves,
of course. In boxing, you need box. Gloves. Los guantes. Si los necesita. A ver, head protection sometimes is necessary. La protección de cabeza, protector de cabeza es necesario. Los guantes también, ¿sí? Mouthguard, protector de boca también. El que no sirve es stick. Stick es como un pedacito de palo. Sí, es como un palito, ¿sí? Entonces, ahí está la que no encabeza ahí, ¿no? Okay, and finish. Very good. Very good. This exercise is very important because you develop the listening skill, ¿no? Estos ejercicios son buenísimos para eso, desarrollar la escucha. Okay, well, in this moment, I share again the presentation. I know. Okay, well, you can see the video, and in this moment, look at the sport and games, okay? Estos son algunos deportes, este es el de vocabulary of the sport and games. Pay attention. Finally, the class, I share the video, and where do you find the pronunciation of this vocabulary, ¿sí? Al final de la clase les voy a compartir un video donde ustedes pueden ver con mayor detenimiento la pronunciación de estas expresiones para que las mecanicen en un ratico que tengan, se desestresen de algo y ustedes escuchan las palabritas y así mejoren su pronunciación, ¿no? Pero vamos a mirar a ver cómo nos va ahora. Entonces, the first block, read Sebastian, the second block, read Natalia, the third block, block de vocabulary, read Luz Kelly, and finally, and follow Natalia, Rubiela, okay? Beginner, Sebastián.
Yes, teacher. Archery, badminton.
Archery. Ojo, badminton. Badminton, la T casi no se escucha, es badminton, badminton, badminton. Es confusita, pero es algo así. La T casi no suena. O sea, badminton no. Badminton. Yes. Okay, badminton. Continue.
Cricket.
Cricket.
Bowling.
Bowling.
Boxing.
Boxing.
Curtin.
Curling.
Curling.
Curling. No. Okay, continue. Natalia, please, fast.
Okay. Tennis, skateboarding, mm-hmm. Surfing, hockey, figures, skating.
Oh, figure skating. Figure skating. Recordemos que la T y la D suena como R. Figure skating. Okay. Continue.
Yoga.
Okay, very good. Luz Kelly, please help me.
Fencing. Fitness.
Yes.
Gymnastic. Kere.
Gymnastic.
Kere. Uh-huh. Volleyball.
Okay, pay attention here.
Weightlifting.
Continue, Rubiela, please. Rubiela.
Yes, please. Teacher.
Help me, please.
Teacher, lo que pasa es que no miro bien. Pero voy a tratar.
Okay, excuse me. I get a beer.
Ah, listo. Gracias. Thank you.
Okay.
Basketball. Baseball.
Baseball.
baseball. Rugby. Writing.
Wrestling. Wrestling.
Wrestling.
Wrestling.
Eating.
Hi. Ojo que esa palabra es muy conocida. Hi. High jumping.
High jumping.
Ajá.
Entonces, high gliding.
High gliding. High hang gliding.
Hang glider.
Gliding. Okay, Sebastián, please help me, please.
Car racing.
Yeah.
Cycling.
Mm-hmm.
Running. Table tennis. Fishing. Judo. Climbing.
Natalia, please help me.
Billboards.
Teacher.
Help me, please, Natalia.
Billboards, ball, shooting,
big horse racing, pool.
Pool.
Recorte, cuando vemos una O, doble O, suena como una O, pool. Billiard or pool. Pool is for US, for American expression, ¿no? Una expresión americana. Si vamos a hablar como británico, podemos decir billiards, ¿ok? Continue. Okay.
Shooting.
Okay.
Horse racing, horseback
riding,
horseback golf,
riding,
football, soccer,
football or soccer. Okay, very good. Yes. Pay attention here in this part. I don't know that you can see better. ¿Sí pueden ver aquí la presentación completa? Can you see the screen, complete the screen? ¿La pueden ver completica? Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Oh, better. It's better, good. Okay, pay attention. It's very important that you identify when do you have to use the verbs play, do, and go. Because the games or the activities have se usan más, son más usuales con todos estos verbos, ¿no? Por lo menos play, you can have to use with sailing. No, you have to use play when activities that use a ball, board, games, musical and instrument. O sea, ustedes pueden utilizar el verbo play para actividades que se usan con balones, con juegos, instrumentos musicales, juegos de tablero, de mesa, de tablero, en fin, ¿sí? Y is generally used to competitive team sports, ¿sí? Y generalmente es usado para juegos de deportes de equipos competitivos. Pay attention, it's the same. You can say play golf or go golf, ¿sí? Play golf or go or play or go golfing, ¿sí? Go golfing para decir ir a golf. Yo voy a ir a jugar golf, ¿sí? Entonces, ustedes lo pueden decir go golfing o play golf, ¿ok? Lucas, you can say play football, play basketball, play volleyball, play tennis, play rugby, play hockey, play the guitar, play poker, play golf, ¿sí? Ojo que la L no suena, play golf, play cards, play chess, play dominoes, play computer games, play baseball, play the violin, play the drums. Remember that drums is tambores, batería, and so on, okay? When do you have to use go? Okay, pay attention here. You have to use go when the activity that finished with ing. Cuando las actividades finalizan en ing, ¿sí? And you have to use, is generally use the activities that you can do alone or with others, okay? For example, when you say go sailing, go cycling, go riding, go skiing, go surfing, go swimming, go bungee jumping, go diving, go dancing, okay? And the verbs do, you have to use with activities that do not to use a verb or and do not ending with ing. Yes? Ustedes utilizan el do con actividades que no usan el balón, ¿sí? Y que no finalizan con ing, ¿ya? But this verb is usually generally used for different kinds of exercise to strengthen your body. Yes? O sea, aquí vamos a utilizar este do para ejercicios, para diferentes clases de ejercicios que muestren, que representen o que ayuden a darle fuerza, a darle fuerza al cuerpo, que necesitan impulsos, movimientos del cuerpo. Si nosotros analizamos el go, puede hacer actividades en equipos o solos. Y aquí en el play es cuando ustedes hacen deportes en equipo y necesitan muchas veces balones u otras herramientas, ¿sí? Pay attention here. We don't use the verb make to talk about sport. No pueden usar el make para hablar de deportes. Eso sería a big error, ¿ok? They use in this place, there are exceptions. Hay una excepción. What is the exception? Pay attention. When do you do the fancy? Fancy es esgrima, ¿sí? Es el deporte de esgrima. Cuando ustedes van a hablar de boxing, de bodybuilding, de weightlifting, you have to use with the verb do. ¿Sí? Nosotros aquí nos dicen que el do no se utiliza con ing, pero con estos verbos, con estas acciones, con estos deportes o actividades, sí nos toca que utilizar el do más, no el go. Why, ¿sí? Why, pay attention. Why, ¿por qué? ¿Por qué no se puede utilizar? Look at this. If you analyze, you need a small space. Why? You need a small space in this with these games. Sí, ustedes necesitan espacios pequeños para hacer boxeo, boxing, fencing, bodybuilding, para hacer fisicoculturismo y para hacer pesas, weightlifting. Sí, para levantar pesas también necesitan espacios pequeños, sí, small space. When you go swimming, when you go cycling, or riding, yes, you need a large space. Ustedes necesitan espacios más grandes, ¿sí? Como necesitan espacios más grandes, pues es más usual utilizar el go que el do. Eso es como más que todo de interpretación, de análisis, de acuerdo al espacio donde se juegan esos deportes, donde se hacen, ¿sí? Entonces, lo que conclusión, lo que necesitamos aquí analizar es que boxes, fencing, bodybuilding, waiting and lighting, you have to use we do, no go, with go, ¿ok? No vamos a utilizar el go con estos deportes o estos juegos. ¿Quedó claro, my dear students? Understand me?
Yes.
¿Me entendieron?
Yes, teacher. Yes,
teacher. Okay. Yes, teacher. Very good. Give me. Okay. Pay attention here. Yes, pay attention here. The expression for you, the expression likes and dislikes, ¿sí? Las expresiones más usuales para decir lo que me gusta y lo que no me gusta. What is this expression? Pay attention. Aquí tenemos I like, that is expression more usual, muy usual. I love, I enjoy, I adore, I'm crazy about, ¿sí? I'm crazy about, I'm mad about, I enjoy, I enjoy, ¿sí? Estoy loco o encantado, significan estas dos, ¿sí? And enjoy, yo lo disfruto, ¿ok? When you dislike some things or some action, you can say, I don't like, I dislike, I abhor, ¿sí? Abhor, ¿sí? Abhor is aborrecer, I abhor, ¿sí? Abhor. Yes, the pronunciation is I author. I can bear. I can bear is the saying in Spanish, no lo puedo soportar, ¿sí? I can stand. Puede significar en Spanish, no aguanto, ¿sí? No lo soporto. Es muy similar a I can bear, sí, pero este es que no aguanto más, no aguanto esta actividad, no aguanto hacer the weightlifting, no aguanto levantar pesas, sí, esa es una expresión para decir que no me gusta, sí. And I detest es que yo detesto, no, para nada, no me gusta absolutamente nada de esto, ¿ok? Well, pay attention, this is the review because the last class So this topic. Esto es un repaso porque ya nosotros lo vimos en la clase pasada, ¿sí? When you have to use like, likes, don't like, and doesn't like. Remember, when you have to use like, you have to use with the personal pronouns I, you, we, and they. Yes? When you say I like flowers, I like chocolates, I like fast food, I like cigarettes. But when you have to say that the third person like, don't forget, use the rules in the present simple. No podemos olvidar el uso de las reglas del presente simple for this person, para estas pronombres personales, ¿no? Entonces, si analizamos, aquí ya aparece la S, ¿sí? Esa es la regla, ¿no? He likes snakes, she likes chocolate, he likes bones, ¿ya? When you have to say negative expression, don't forget, use the auxiliar. No olvidemos decir el auxiliar. What is the auxiliar? Don't or doesn't. When you have to use don't and when you have to use doesn't, remember, you have to use don't with the personal pronouns I, you, we, and they. I don't like flowers, you don't like chocolate, we don't like fast food, and they don't like cigarettes. Pay attention here. The doesn't auxiliar, you have to use with the third person. Yes, he doesn't like snake, she doesn't like chocolate, doesn't like bones. Remember, when you have to use doesn't, you can put the rules in the verse. Si ustedes utilizan el auxiliar doesn't, No pueden utilizar, no pueden poner la de regla. ¿Por qué? Porque la regla aquí ya sobraría, porque ya aquí nos tenemos el auxiliar que nos fortalece ese verbo, que nos da la afirmación de que nos está ratificando que esa acción está en forma negativa. Por lo tanto, no se le aplica la regla de la S o la regla de la S o la S en el verbo, ¿ok? When you have to use the questions, sí, pay attention. Remember, you have to use the auxiliar do or does. Yes. Do you like chocolate? This question has or this question needs the answer. And the answer can be positive or negative. And it is positive, you can say, yes, I do. And it is negative, you can say, no, I don't. In this case, okay, when you have to use do. But you have to use does, the auxiliar does. You remember, you can say, does she like chocolate? Or does he like snakes? Si a él le gustan las serpientes, ¿sí? Entonces, you have to use, you have to say, say the answer. The answer can be negative or positive. If it's positive, you can say, yes, she does. Yes, she does. And if it's negative, yeah, you can say, no, she doesn't. Okay? Please pay attention. When you have the auxiliar does in negative question, please don't put on the verb the or yes. No pongamos la S ni la ES al verbo. Why? Because the auxiliar is strong the sentence, stronger. Porque el verbo, el auxiliar fortalece toda la oración y ya el verbo, pues, no necesita la regla, la terminación S o el sufijo S o ES. ¿Quedó claro? Bueno, esto aquí sí es importante. Vamos aquí a analizar esta partecita, por favor, y les agradezco que me quiero colocar acá. Vamos a agrandar este puntero. Ojo acá. Bueno, like and verbs ing, ¿sí? El verbo gustar más el verbo con ing, ¿sí? Ustedes pueden usar el verbo like, you can have to use, ¿sí? Yeah, sometimes you can use the verbs like next to. Ustedes pueden muchas veces usar el verbo like al lado del to, o sea, de la forma infinitiva del verbo. For example, here, I like to sleep. Yes? Or sometimes you have to use the verb like with the other verb with ing. O sea, pueden usar el verbo like con otro verbo con ing. ¿Sí? Esas son las dos formas que podemos hacerlo. Para que no sea como tan, o sea, para darle más nivel a nuestra conversación, le podemos decir así, utilizar el verbo como con el verbo con ing, ¿sí? Ambos podemos usar I like to sleep o I like sleeping, pero el que nos da más nivel es este, ¿no? Y es como más usual en la parte fluida, en la parte del speaking, es más usual esta forma, ¿listo? Bueno, pay attention here. We sometimes use like plus infinitive to talk about habits. ¿Sí? Ustedes muchas veces utilizan este verbo para hablar de cosas, hablar de hábitos y de elecciones, choices. Eso lo podemos utilizar, el like más infinitivo, para hablar de hábitos y de elecciones. Ojo acá, pay attention. Like plus verbs and ing It's more common to say you like doing something in general, ¿sí? Ustedes usualmente pueden usar, es muy común utilizar el verbo like más otro verbo con ing. Sí, es muy común para hablar de las cosas que me gustan, de las cosas que generalmente me gustan, ¿sí? For example, when you say, I like to eat chocolate for breakfast. Eso es un hábito. It's my habit, yeah?